I guess if you're a novice coder like me, or you're a veteran, this is a useful application. And I guess you're targeting those two very different end markets.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, Ed, what we have seen in the last year is that companies no longer just look at digital transformation. They're actually looking into the AI transformation. And GitHub Copilot started it all by giving developers AI-based auto-suggestions, you know, auto-completion in the editor. And with Copilot Enterprise, it can now be customized to all the internal knowledge of an organization, the code base. Imagine, you know, you're a new developer at Bloomberg TV. It's your first day, and you can just ask Copilot how things are done at Bloomberg, all the institutional knowledge at your fingertips.
A part of this, in some of the similar tools I've seen, is kind of the predictive nature, right? You're writing a line of code, and the rest is auto-completed. What is the performance and competence level of your technology vis-a-vis a veteran coder who could write it themselves?
You know, it actually depends on what you're doing yourself. We see a lot of developers are learning to use Copilot while typing code. You know, you figure out when you write a couple of characters in your editor that if you do it in a certain way, you get a better suggestion, you get a better answer. And so developers increase their proficiency level as they're using Copilot. We see that they're getting more productive, you know, up to 55% in case studies that we have ran. And we are seeing developers actually be measurable, more fulfilled, more happy.
Thomas, Microsoft, your parent company, was pretty stoked about the base version of Copilot. Do you think $39 a month will see the enterprise version gain traction?
Absolutely. You know, the traction that we have seen over the last year has been phenomenal. We have over 50,000 organizations already onboarded to Copilot, more than 1.3 million paid users. And we see a lot of excitement from all kinds of industries. No, it's no longer right. Just the cool startups and the tech companies. It's you know, pharmaceutical companies, automotive companies, lots of financial services institutions, the global system integrators like Accenture. And so we see tremendous excitement there. We have run the preview of Copilot Enterprise for the last 3 months and received feedback from companies like Figma, Shopify, or Telos, telling us that the collaboration is getting so much better if Copilot knows about what's happening within the company.
Bloomberg reported earlier this month that Apple is looking to do something very similar with Xcode, and you know, a very similar tool. What do you make of that? You know, clearly this is becoming a battleground, the use of generative AI within the writing of code.
You know, I think as a developer, this is the most exciting era that I have seen over the last 30 years, where all these companies, including Microsoft and GitHub, are working to make developers more productive, to have them focus on the things they love doing and have AI help them with the things that they don't love to do, right? This is exciting for developers. The workload, the amount of code that developers have to manage today is so big that we really need to bring the effort down of doing all this work, maintaining all this legacy code that lasts back, you know, until the 1960s with COBOL and Fortran and other languages that are still running in our production system. So it's really exciting. You don't see all the innovation, and we hope we stay at the forefront of this.